What is up, YouTube? This will be the very first, I guess, filmed YouTube video, because I'm going to be migrating other videos, but filmed YouTube video on this channel. If you came here from my other channel, Derb Codes, I just want to thank you so much. If you're new here, please just hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you know when I'm going to be posting. The goal is going to be pretty much every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. But I have a couple things already filmed where I'm going to be doing 5 days in a row for like a hot pack series or a box opening. And I've already got 10 to 15 episodes already filmed, so that will be coming out in the coming weeks. Today, generally I do Mail Day Mondays. I have a special one here. If you caught my last episode on my other YouTube channel, you know that I shouted out 10 people from the community. Actually, it was 11. It was a little misleading. I said 10, but it was 11. And I'm shouting out my buddy Big Tuck TV today because he had sent me a care package. I'm excited to open this. And then I still have some leftover packages that I didn't get to in that last video. I'll leave a link to it, and I'm going to bring that video over as well. We'll probably just have a playlist of Mail Day Mondays, so just look around, and then, yeah, we're just going to jump right into this stuff. So, like I said, if you missed my last video that I made on Derb Codes, definitely go watch it, because there's a lot of awesome YouTubers there. A lot of people in the community that are just awesome and just like to give away just amazing cards, talk about cards, have a vast knowledge of cards. And I'm highlighting some of the ones that I had received, you know, from giveaways and just being a part of their community. They gave out some cool cards. And so I'm putting those there, and then I'm going to put whatever Tuck has sent me in this package. I'll put him up there as well. And then we'll just go through some of the stuff that I had purchased and who I'm buying. Spoiler alert, I am a Cleveland fan. So you're going to see a lot of Indians and Browns and Cavs stuff. Definitely, I still look at LBJ just because he's from my hometown of Akron. And I really just want him to win more championships. I think he's got a great chance this year. But anyways, let's just jump in. So see, at Big Tuck TV. So if you guys are here, this guy rocks. And you definitely should check out his content. If you haven't, I'll leave his information. I'm going to have like a little thing down here that has stuff about his channel. And then in the description below will be a link to his channel. Definitely check him out. I might have a little cutaway here just so you can see like what his channel is about. But definitely go in and look for him. He messaged me. Funny story is, I think I told this in the last one, but I'm going to get to use my trusty knife from Card Collector. Another guy in the community has his own card shop down in Columbus, and they got their own Facebook group where you can like buy and sell and trade and run Razzes and Fatals and stuff too. If people are interested in that, just let me know and I can get you the link. But anyways, you know, I'm coming over to this community. I saw Gary V talk about sports cards, how they're coming back. A couple years ago, and I just didn't think anything of it because I'd just been out of it for so long. I collected cards for 20 years and or 15 years or so, and I haven't collected in, you know, 15, 18 years. And I come back, and so I'm just looking for people, and lo and behold, Big Tuck's channel comes up. I think, like I said in that previous video, he was opening like Pokemon or something like that. But I know Tuck from a mutual friend in the gaming industry, and I was just surprised. I didn't know that he was making videos. I just had started making these types of videos, and yeah, it was just really cool to see him. From there, we messaged each other on the Discord because we're in the same Discord, and he said, "Hey, can you send me your address? I want to send you a care package." I was like, "Dude, that's awesome. Yeah, of course." And over the course of that time, I found out that he is a Celtics fan. So if you guys see this and you go sub to him and eventually you make a care package for him, he is a Celtics fan. So go and, you know, start collecting some Celtics stuff to send on over, which is funny because I was like, how did you become a Celtics fan? Because he lives in Texas. But he had a friend who was a Celtics fan, and when they won their championship back in, I think, 2008, that's probably, like, where he became open second. Open me second, he says. Okay. All right. Anyways, let's just jump into this. I hope that you guys like this, and like I said, if you do, give us a like and a subscribe, and definitely go check out Big Tuck's. But anyways, like I said, we found each other that way. It was just kind of funny because we knew each other. Is this a note maybe, or is this just saying enjoy? Okay, just enjoy. All right, let's do this. Let's do this, Tuck. All right, we start off with a Carlos Santana. I always liked Carlos Santana. I was surprised when he went away for a year or two. But I'm glad that we got him back. And this looks like a prism. It is a prism. He always had power. He never really hit for, like, great average sometimes. And he's very streaky. But since he's been back, I think he's been a more complete player. And, yeah, I'm expecting the Indians. I know they were a disappointment last year. But I'm expecting them to make a bounce back. I know we only got, like, 60 games to do something. But I think we have a shot to be in the playoffs this year. And hopefully this might be the last year because, like I said, Lindor, I think, pretty sure is going to Boston. Then we got a Colin Sexton, another young Cav. We got Garland and some other players this year, but Sexton, I think, is a good young player. I'm not sure if we're going to be what we're going to do with him in the future, but Larry Nance, you guys might know that his dad played for the Cavs before Larry Nance came over. You might know him also from the Lakers, but Larry Nance, full of energy, and he definitely could put up some good games. After that, we got Tristan Thompson. Let me move this cardboard out of the way. Tristan Thompson, he was the same guy. Like, he really showed himself. I don't know if it was when LeBron, I think it was when LeBron had come back. He's from Canada and obviously dated the Kardashians, which is what he's probably famous for most people. But he had an endless motor, and he was like an offensive rebound machine. And I think they're looking to keep him, even though I'm not sure if he wants to stay in Cleveland or not. There's this meme of a video. Maybe I'll show the play. I'll look for the play, and I'll edit it in here so you guys can see it.
Simmons tipped it. Thompson recoups it. Now Simmons, a smart play here because Thompson is forced to handle with the shot clock running down. There's Thompson wildly throwing it up. Well done by...
But the meme is that Tristan Thompson is doing everything he can to get traded out of Cleveland. K-Love, which I love K-Love, and he really, like, completely changed his game to fit into the system that Cleveland had. People forget how big of a monster Kevin Love was. I mean, you should look at his stats when he was before he came to Cleveland. This dude had like 40-20 games, like at least a couple a year. 40-20s. You know, like he was putting up crazy rebounds, crazy numbers. And then Cleveland got him and asked him, hey, man, can you lose like 40 pounds and just go out and shoot threes? So, like, I mean, he still gets rebounds and stuff, but like, mad props to him, and we got obviously a ring because of it. The only problem with him obviously is that his health has been bad for a big guy. He's had back problems and stuff like that. But then we got a new rookie here in Dylan Windler. Well, this is from the Mosaic stuff, and after that we got Kevin Porter Jr. Like Kevin Porter Jr. KPJ, I think he's got a bright future. We got all these young, like Darius Garland, Sexton, Kevin Porter Jr., all these guys. That's why I'm wondering, like, what we're going to do with all these guards. I don't know. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. But definitely cool. Definitely cool. Now we got the Tristan Thompson in a red and blue reactive. I can't remember what the name of this one is. I think red reactive or blue reactive. Red, blue reactive. They come in a specific mosaic. I know that. And behind him, we got a Dylan Windler in the green. Another cool card. Whoa. And the orange. I haven't actually seen an orange card yet. This would be my first one. So let me put him here. And are these numbered? No. I think these might come out of a specific series too. But the problem with me is I haven't been able to find any mosaic at all. Like, I ripped one box of mosaic, which that'll be in the series I have coming up where I rip boxes, but I just haven't found anything, so I had to buy that at full price online, And, I don't know. We'll see what that comes out like. Then we got Kevin Love in a couple of different prisms. We got green and pink. These I know come in the cello packs. I'm not sure what... Yeah. Oh, and we got another... Is this another orange? Cool. And it's Darius Garland. Nothing against old Dylan Windler. I just... Darius Garland, I think, is a little bit better. He's putting up some good numbers there. I'm surprised. I'll see, like, what happens with the in the offseason. But him and KPJ, I think, are some good ones to hold on to. So that is the first pack. Pretty cool. We've got tons of prisms here from him. We got... Oh, I'll show him. Carlos Santana, which is awesome. And then we got... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 prism cards. I mean, Big Tuck's going out of his way here. Not to mention all the other rookies and stuff. I'm going to set these aside. To go with pack number 2, he says, open me second. All right. We open a new second here. Dun, 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 dun. Since this is getting a long video, maybe I'll just cut it after this, and then I'll do the mail day afterwards. All right, so we got Terry McLaurin. This is some Ohio State stuff. If you guys don't know, I constantly wear Ohio State. I got an Ohio State hat on right now. And you see some Ohio State in the back, which he probably knows us from because our buddy Lloyd, all those guys, they live in Columbus and are always, he's got Ohio State fan stuff. He's got Ohio State everything as well. So, yeah, we bond in that experience. Terry McLaurin now over with the Ravens. And then we got Mr. Dwayne Haskins. I'm excited to see what he does when he comes back. He's going to be having – he's in Washington, so you know how that goes. He's in a big market, a lot of eyes. Hopefully he comes out throwing like he did when he was at Ohio State. Here we got the Browns huddle up. Yeah, Odell sitting back here. You see Baker in there. Looks like Higgins. Really cool. Definitely like that. We'll put our Browns up here in front of Tuck for now, just because I love the Browns so much. Michael Thomas, an Ohio State guy. Pretty much like, I don't know, man. The problem with where the situation he's in is that he is going to be losing Drew Brees in a year or 2 years. So I'm not sure he's going to be able to keep up the pace that he's on. But, man, he has been killing it, you know, with receiving. Then we had Ted Ginn Jr. Guy was just a lightning rod. He's so fast. Also Ohio State guy, as you know. We got Greedy Williams. I think we picked up Greedy, if I'm correct, the 2019. Yeah, he's just a 2019. We picked him up in, what round was it? I can't remember. Anyways, I thought that we did a really good job with our DBs. We had just picked up Ward like the year before, and Ward came out and was like a pro, made the Pro Bowl and stuff like that. And then we got Greedy as well. Like, I thought we had a really good shot to, but it seemed like that was part of our issue last year. And the running game, we didn't really stop in the running game either. So I think that's going to change this year. I think that the Browns are just going to be an offensive force, but we just hope that the defense keeps up. Then we got Kareem Hunt, a late addition. Obviously, he had some controversy, but I think maybe possibly one of the best 1-2 combo in the backfield in the entire league. Then we got J.K. Dobbins here. We got a rookie card for him, huh? I'm excited to see what Dobbins does, man. He is a beast. I wonder what he's going to do in the NFL, though. You know, with everyone says, like, even, you know, the practice squad running backs can make it in the NFL. So I hope that he's able to keep a job and does well. Then we got Chase Young. I want to see if his game translates to the NFL as well. Obviously, everyone knows how big of a beast he was. But at the end of the season, he was kind of like non-existent. So I'm interested to see what he does. Maybe he just decided to back off at the end of the season because he didn't want to get hurt. I don't know. You never know. But I'm interested to see how he does in the NFL as well. We got another Dwayne Haskins. This one's red. I don't know if that means anything. See how this one's like dark? I don't know. Anyways, we got another Dwayne Haskins. I'll put him on this one. We got an Okuda rookie. Basically, he had an insane, I don't know if you guys know, but he's like insane. Never had a penalty. Dude was just a shutdown corner, and I'm excited to see if he's like the next big corner in the league because he's obviously he went high, but he was a beast. Then we got a Joe Burrow rookie when it was Ohio State. Holy crap. That's sick. This is my first one for sure. Actually, it's a lot of my first with football. I haven't really opened much football. Been buying a lot of Bakers, as you know, but so I'm going to put him in front of my Browns for now, even though he's not a Browns player, and even though he's not in Ohio State whenever he won the Heisman. We'll put him there anyways. And we got a couple more Terrys. So we got a Crusade and a Prism. That's pretty sweet. Old Scary Terry. I hate that he's on the Ravens, but I love that he came from Ohio State. So I got to root for him a little bit, but not against us. Not against the Brownies, you know what I mean? Here we got Michael Thomas here. We're talking about when he was on Ohio State. Real cool, real cool. He was a 3-star recruit, it says. We got Dobbins, another rookie, Dobbins. Holy crap. And he's sending, what is this? Is this what the Ultra Ones are? Yeah. Look at this. Okay. So we got ourselves a Jordan Fuller. Real cool. Wow. That looks like it's on card, too. No, there's a sticker there. Sticker there, but still, that's sick. That is sick. Sorry, Burrow. Sorry, Browns. Sorry, Big Talk TV on a white card. We got to put ourselves Jordan Fuller up here. Real cool. Super cool, man. Dude, that's awesome. Well, Tuck, I loved the package. Now that I've got your address from where you sent it, I have quite the stack of Celtic stuff. And if you like other teams, you know, besides the Celtics, you know, if it's like a, you know, you're down there in Texas, if that's the only team that you like, then I guess we'll just keep it at that. But if you, you know, got a football team that you like, even if it's unfortunately the Cowboys or something, you know, I'll start throwing in some football as well instead of just because football's coming up. I know basketball is still coming up too, but basketball I think starts July 31st. Dude, real cool. A lot of cool cards in here. But anyways, let me know what you guys thought of this cool package. Definitely, definitely go check out. I'm going to bring out his card again, his white card that I... Where did I just put it? The Big Tuck TV. Go check him out. Like I said, I'll put some content in here. I'll have like his thing down there in a little bit. And the information for it below that. I'm sorry, I took my time through the card just because I'm so thankful. These are all PC for me. So I'm a Cleveland fan. I was expecting some stuff. I wasn't expecting all of this. Not to mention an auto there. That's insane. Anyways, I just want you guys to go check out Big Tuck TV. He's an awesome guy, putting out a lot of cool content from everything. From like I said, he's got Pokemon stuff all the way to football, basketball, baseball. Real cool, ripping a lot of good product too. He opened up some Mosaic recently, just killed it. You should go check out those big hits that he got. But anyways, I'll see you guys in the next video. I want to thank you so much for coming by and subscribing. This is, like I said, the first video on this channel, and there's going to be a lot of content coming up, so make sure you hit that notification bell. I'll see you guys.